Hello and welcome everyone to another episode. Yes, so it's time to get a crew down. I ended up doing some testing and I would have picked up last episode on the construction and just putting together the base and everything else, but I ended up noticing and finding out that basically the base itself will not stay on the surface of minmus with basically no crew inside of it, so there was really no way around that. So the one thing I gotta mention, actually a few things, for subscriber submissions, if you guys have anything that you would like to submit for me to fly, I will be covering a little bit more on subscriber submissions once we get into orbit and everything else, but if you guys have anything for me to fly, definitely send it. It's always open, so whenever you want to send something, just send it. It may take a while, but I will try to get it in the next episode. And, yeah, so I want your guys' feedback, you know, on the modded series. I do know that, number one, if you guys have suggestions for mods that I should use, definitely let me know about that, because I will definitely implement them if I like the mod and everything else. If I care enough to put it in the game, definitely will put that in the game. So if you have any cool mods, you know anything, I know a few people have suggested, like I believe it was like KY Rocketry, or I know TAC life support. The only problem I have with life support stuff is the fact that I kind of, you know, wanna be able to play this game without having to worry constantly about, like, making sure my crew is okay and everything else, because it is a little bit of an annoyance to be playing and then constantly having to take care of your crew and all your crews on all of your vessels and everything else, and I just don't wanna have to worry about, you know, constantly having to supply them with stuff. I don't know how long it actually lasts, like if you were to do a resupply mission or something like that. Like, I really don't want something that requires insane amounts of upkeep, because of the fact that I want to play this and have fun. I don't want to constantly have to think that I have to do stuff in order to maintain, like, living crews and stuff like that. So there was another one, I think it was like an updated nav ball mod or something like that. I looked at that and I'm not overly concerned with that, but I'll definitely, maybe I'll install it and just take a look, but at least for right now, I think I'm just going to kind of stick with this. But that's as far as I can go with all of that goodness. So I mean, maybe I'll have a change of hearts and I'll definitely take, you know, a better look at everything, but for right now, I think I'm going to stick without any kind of, like, life support stuff or anything like that. But if there's, like, a mod where I just want to make sure that everything's, like, completely compatible with, like, Keythane and stuff like that. I mean, if it's compatible with Keythane, or if there's a way that they can produce their own food or something like that, where it's just an added module, but if it's just, like, basically launching extra stuff, to me, I just look at it as extra parts of stuff I don't really need. So that's kind of where I stick with that. But the other mods I was really looking at, and, you know, there was a few other ones I wanted to add, and certain things just seem a little bit too overly complex. One of them was, somebody suggested a robotic arm mod, and I don't know what mod exactly you're talking about, because there's Damned Robotics, and there's a few other ones, and I can't think of which one you are talking about, because I was looking through all of them, and there's another one that is basically like the robotic arm on the ISS, but when I looked at that and I watched somebody use it, like, sure, it's a pretty cool thing, but it's so overly complex. Something that is very simple it took something that's very simple of docking and made it so overly complex that I don't even see the purpose in using it. So that's where I kind of stand with at least that specific mod. It was like, it took them like In the video, it took him somewhere around like 15 minutes just to dock up one module to his space station, whereas I could have docked that like in like a minute. So it wasn't even that big of a deal to me, and that stuff isn't so much of a big deal to me as other mods are really awesome, like the Kerbal attachment system and stuff like that. So I don't know, we'll see when everything, you know, just keep suggesting and I'll keep looking them up and I'll keep updating my mods. But you know, for right now I kind of just want to stick with what I got, but at the same time, keep suggesting. That's all I'm going to say. And I'm going to disable this because I ended up finding out you can use the small guy here, and you can use that for basically satellite scanning. I thought that you can only use the satellite scan part or whatever you want to call it. But yeah, things are looking pretty good. That's all I can say. So I definitely want to get the work done on the minmus base this episode. I went through and checked everything out, and I'm going to need Kerbals on the ground because of the fact that this game, I have my, whatchamacallit, I'm like completely out of it right now. I have the debris set to zero, so because of that, means that if anything is unmanned that doesn't have a command module attached to it in any kind of way, it gets deleted. So it is a little bit of a problem doing playing the game this way, but at the same time I just don't like to deal with debris and all that stuff. It's not worth it to me. I have no interest in building debris-free craft and stuff like that. I don't care enough about that kind of stuff, or at least that aspect of the game, to really, at least for now. Once again, I always have a change of hearts, because I remember at one point in time I said I'd never play a modded game ever. So, you know, once again, I had a little bit of a change of hearts. Most of it was kind of due to demand, but, you know, everything is always due to demand, so. Anyways, guys, I'm going to see you once we get close to the surface of Minmus so we can get our setup done and all that other good stuff. So I'll see you then. and Rebecca, it's, yeah. So, this is looking pretty good. I haven't experienced any other problems other than that stage blowing up, which I wanted it to. I wanted to crash it into the surface. So, yeah, I kind of got rid of it, and it was a little bit of an unconventional landing. I know I probably could have landed a lot more efficiently, but I just didn't want to waste the time and all of that. And I brought way more fuel than I needed, and it was a massive rocket that I launched in the first place with this whole thing. So, definitely could have probably settled for something a lot less, but I wasn't really looking to change my rocket design. I really don't care so much about changing the rocket design. That's one thing I really never cared so much for. But this thing just keeps exploding over here. Oh god. There we go. Come on, come on. Yeah, that was good enough. So let's get these guys over to the base. Hey, come on. Nope, nope, nope. There, come on. Oh, there we go. Let's see, come on. I love minmus because it's, oh god, oh god, oh god, there we go. It's such an easy moon to build on. They're really, you just don't even have to worry about anything. Oh god, there we go, come on, grab. There we go. Good job, Mr. Jeb. I think that was Jeb. Nope, that was Bill. So let's get Bob out. I plan on taking everyone out, and I'm just going to put one guy in each hab module. Oh my god, that... oh, he is not in good places right now. You okay, buddy? You just hit your face on a fuel tank. Okay, yeah, it looks like you recovered. Let's go. Oh, yeah, don't hit the panel. Alright, come on over here. And we're going to be able to test out our crane today, which is always really good things. Let's see. Oh god, nope, not that. These are not what we're looking for. There we go. And another EVA. Yeah, there we go. And get out your... Oh my god, Jeb. Don't hit your face. You don't want to be like Bill and crack your faceplate or anything like that. Slow down. There we go. You're the only one who really seems to know what he's doing. Come on. Oh, whoa, whoa. Oh my god. Just get in. There we go. Just hop in there. And we can decouple this. And since we're not really going to be needing this anymore, we can just kind of take this here. Alright, I did decouple those. And we're just going to lean this over on its side. Just take off a little bit. Lean it over on its side like that. That looks good. We'll switch the craft. See you later. Thank you for all the help and everything, but we don't need you anymore. And this thing should have... Okay, it did. I was just making sure... Alright, we gotta change this over too, because I don't believe this is going to be... Yeah, it's set as a ship, but we'll change it over to a rover for now. And get this guy moving. Now, the best part, too, with this thing is I don't even have to... I basically don't even have to use the turning... I don't even have to turn the wheels, you know, if I want to turn right or left or anything like that. I can just use the SAS maneuvers, or the SAS movement to turn the wheels on this thing. I don't even have to turn right or left. I don't even have to change anything else. And it's kind of like that too with the crane as well, but it's a little bit smaller. So I tried to put as much as I can on... Oh, there we go. Slow down. Stop. There we go. Yeah, that works. kind of bring it a little bit further away because I don't want the engines activating and screwing up anything. So put our brakes on, and we gotta get one guy out here. I should put this down, you know, that would look nice. And turn on the lights as well. So let's see, Ivy, there we go, we'll get Neddorf. The hatch is obstructed. This has never happened to me before. That is not cool. Alright, whatever. Well, let me just try this one more time. I don't know what I did wrong. Eh, whatever. I'm not even gonna bother with that. So, let's see. Where is... I've never actually obstructed the hatches before. So that is kind of weird for me, but... Oh, whatever. Once they all get connected anyways, it's not going to be that big of a deal. Turn off the brakes. Yeah, there we go. We can get out of the way. So this one, too, I did equip it with the seismic control and the thermometer. Once again, I like to put stuff that really doesn't have to do much with the craft on there because I think it looks cool, but, I mean, that's just me. I like it when it kind of has a little bit of its own flair. But there we go. So we'll put on the brakes and I'll switch over here. There we go. No, we got to switch to this guy here. So we're going to get rid of all of this too. I think that module should have crashed or something. Yeah, it did do something. So we'll quick save just in case something happens. Are they still moving? I don't know. Let's get rid of this. So we're going to do the same thing, basically. Just kind of lean this over. Oh, God. Rename the vessel to debris. Okay. Switch. Oh, God. I will see you guys in a second. Alright, I think I got everything figured out here. We got rid of all the debris and stuff. So, this setup is going to be a little bit tough, I'm thinking. I don't know for sure. So I want this thing facing the mountain side here. I thought that would look really cool. So let's see. We got to get rid of this one. And this one. And turn on the SAS. We don't have... Oh, we do have RCS, but I will be using that RCS fuel if I need it. So let's try this. Alright. No, we need to lean over that way just a little bit. This is pretty freaking intense. Now, I just had an idea. Save myself some time. I could possibly attach these, but I don't think I'm going to do that. Okay, we gotta get rid of this motion. This motion. Alright, now it looks like... Oh, God. Oh, God. Get rid of that speed. Perfect. 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 Now all we gotta do is just spin this thing around. Kind of want to space these out because I figure the crane is going to need a little bit of space to kind of set up and everything else. Alright, alright, alright. Whoa, 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 whoa. That's good. That is more than good. Just kind of line these up a little bit more. Make things just a little bit easier for me. There we go. So we're going to get rid of this thing here. Hopefully I can get rid of it really easily. Alright, just I gotta set this thing as debris, I believe. There we go. Yeah. Now just need to aim it someplace where it's gonna go far, far away. Far, far, far away from us. That's good. See you later. You served us very, 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 very well. I'm just going to wait for it to get a little far away so then we don't have to worry about switching vessels by accident or something. Hopefully it smashes into the surface, otherwise we're going to have some problems later on. Now, I think our rover is either bugged or we have some problems with that, but I think we should be okay with that. Okay. Alright, that's... Oh, God. That's good. There we go. Turn off the SAS. We're not going to need that right now. The SAS, I will say, does come in handy a lot, because I can just basically turn this thing just by tapping, so I don't really have to do much as far as, like, actually turning the wheels in any kind of way. I can just pretty much keep them straight, and it's pretty much happy with that, and I'm pretty happy with that as well, so I'm not going to change that, so let's just stop. I'm gonna have to back up a little bit, I think. Just get this thing right over the middle. I think that should be perfect. And just put the brakes on. Now, I'm going to do a lot of this attachment with the Kerbals themselves because I think I'll be able to get a little bit better. Because these things are just flying around because of the fact that there is some kind of a motion on them. So it's not... uniform or anything like that. They're not gonna come straight down. They're just gonna grab it. Oh God, there we go. Grab it. There we go. And let's see, we're gonna just attach this to like right here. Perfect. And I think I wish I could just grab it from right here, but I don't think it would like that too much. Grab it. There we go. And then just attach it. Nope. There we go. Put it right there. And oh, there we go. Hopefully he doesn't run out of pack fuel. I think we'll be alright. Now, I put these on here because it was kind of a thought afterwards of how hard it is to keep these things stable. So, alright, we're just gonna attach this, like, right up here. Perfect. Alright, we're just gonna get away. Oh my God, what's wrong with you? Oh God, I think you're okay. So let's see, I'm gonna turn off the key control with these because I don't want any mishaps, just to make sure. Wait a minute, is that one enabled? Yeah. Oh, I don't understand what is going on. Alright, that looks good. So it looks like there is no real forces on these. So I'm just going to bring this up a little bit. Wow. That is absolutely perfect. So, actually, I got to turn this down a lot because I had these at like 20, but I don't know what happened. I guess the game just kind of resets them after a while. I'll put it down even lower. That way we're not jerking on this thing like crazy. There we go. That seems like a winner in my book. Alright, we don't even need to turn. I'm just trying to get used to these controls because I gotta get this a little bit higher. You know, I don't mind that it's rocking so much as long as it doesn't hit the ground constantly. Alright, go up a little bit higher. I want this to be, like, super freaking taut so it doesn't move at all, which it looks like that's where I got it right now. It looks like we're stuck a little bit. Oh, God. Something's spazzing out. Okay, so it did not like that. Oh, we gotta go back down again. Actually, I think I'll keep it like this. It's not that bad. I think I can still. It's not gonna move around any, so that's pretty much the only thing. I didn't want it to roll around or move around or anything, so I think we're gonna be okay with this. You know, if anything, I should have grabbed the one that's my wheel is about to hit. Oh god, stop. Stop. There we go. Yeah, this is definitely a lot more involved than my initial design where I just basically drop these things down, or use the rover to basically push these things into place. It's a lot more involved, actually. So, let's get this down. I think this should be close enough for right now. I need to put on the brakes. That way, no movement. Nope, I need to go down. Alright, okay, that's still not that close. I just want it to be able to touch the ground and kind of cancel out some motion here and there. That will kind of help out a little bit. If anything, I'll get Bill over here or whoever to fix that, but I think we're going to be okay. Just speed up ever so nicely. Don't want to tap the base. I just tapped the base. Oh, come on. Turn on the brakes. And I'm going to lower this down a little bit. Nope. This way. Yeah, that's lower. And I think we got to move this guy out of the way for right now in order to really be able to do anything. So I'm just going to turn off the magnet on both of these guys and just reel these in. And I'm going to move this one. I'll see you guys once I get I can get these two closer again, so. Alright, there we go. So we get to test this thing out finally. I don't really have that high of hopes for everything, if that sounds bad. I mean, I don't mean to say that in a bad way, but for some reason, I just don't feel like this is going to be the most logical way of doing things. Let's see, turn off the brakes. There we go. So, we need to get closer. There we go. Alright. Just get a little bit closer, and then that magnetism is going to take hold. At least I hope so. Yeah, there's the magnetism. So we can see what happens. I really don't know what will happen, to be honest. So we'll just put the gear down for right now. I think we're close enough. Oh, God. They already are moving. Oh, nope. That was the wrong way. And just lower it down ever so nicely. Let's see. I really hope that's lined up. Because if not, I'm not going to be very happy. Doesn't seem like it's lined up very well. Well, let me, it looks a little lined up. I mean, I don't know. I'd really have to drop it down and look at it. Let's see. Drop this. Drop that guy. And get rid of that one. So we're really gonna have to take a look at this. I'm not sure if that is like perfectly lined up or not. Because it did move, I don't know what kind of problems may have arisen. I don't know. It seems like it's all right though. I don't know. I'm very particular. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm looking at this and I'm like very skeptical as far as how well this connection is going to be and if everything's going to be all right at the end. So I'll put the gear back down. Just ensuring that. Oh God. Release and bring that back in. Oh, come on. So let's get the second, or I should say third part. Now, I think after this it shouldn't be so bad. It's not going to have any pull on it or anything like that where it's going to really lift it up off the ground like it did before, but I mean, I'm pretty sure it's going to a little bit, but it's not going to be that bad. So let's get this one connected. This thing is very, very weird. That's all I can say is I would definitely prefer using the rover and just knocking them into place as opposed to doing this, but this does kind of work, so I'm not going to knock it fully. Come on. Bring this over. Now this kind of works as far as trying to line up over the top. Let's see. Come on. Now with the bigger modules that I do have planned that I'm going to be bringing here, this will come in very big handy. But as for right now, I don't really think that doing this is going to save a lot of time. The one thing I'm going to do is I'm probably going to have to bring back another rover if I plan on using the rover really, but I don't really have like a lot of plans as far as using the rover, at least for right now. So that kind of isn't really that big of a deal. But we will definitely have to bring another one if I do need it for anything. So there we go. Come on. All right, I think I gotta grab it. Yeah, that's right, I forgot. Come on. I know I can grab it with G, but I just feel like I'm probably going to end up missing it or something. There we go. It's his pack fuel. All right, he's down to like half. Go back up. I wonder if this consumes RCS now. I don't know. That's the one thing I definitely don't know with this game. They might. I know they did change that because I remember I was talking about that a long time ago with the RCS being able to view it up here, but I did not know whether or not they actually changed it or whatever. So grab this. Come on. There we go. Put it right there. That's kind of, I think that's more of the center for these things. It's kind of right in that area. Oh God. Get out of the way. You can just stand right here. I think you'll be okay right there. Perfect. So, yeah, he's definitely not out of the way. If we hit you, I'm sorry. Lift that up. I think, I'm gonna start putting it a little bit more in this area, because I don't think that area is good enough. So let's get this thing on the move. Wrong way. Oh, that's not good. That is not good. There we go. Oh, no. Go back down. There we go. It's starting to freak out. I think it has like a sweet spot, basically. If it's not in that spot, it's just going to start spazzing out. Look out, you're going to Bill? Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're going to get like smacked in the head. Here, I'm sorry. At least, I don't think... Actually, no, you're good. Thought he might have gotten smacked in the head. Getting hit in the face with a 10-ton freaking HAB module. Let's bring this back. Come on. There we go. Let's get a little closer. I think we'll be alright. Because these things have a tendency to kind of pull themselves anyway, so... Once I get it low enough, I think it will be okay to where the module will just kind of want to pull itself into place. I think that's the wrong way. Yes, it is. Let's see. Is it getting that pull? It looks like it, but I'm not sure. Come on. Get that pull. That's not the kind of pull I was asking for. Come on, stop colliding. Alright, it should swing back now. Perfect. Beautiful. Now, I'm going to disconnect. Which one should I disconnect? I think I could get rid of the right... If I'm right, this one should be the wrong one. get rid of this one too. Might as well now. And just lower this down a little bit. It should just snap right into place. Come on. Come on. Oh, you guys are gonna hate me. Come on. Alright, that did not work out so well. Is it off the ground? I mean, I don't know why, but it keeps on wanting to kind of like list over to one side. Do I have the gear down? Yeah, there we go. That might change things a little bit. I'm just gonna keep doing this until it docks up, so I'll see you guys in a second. Yeah, so I got this one connected up, but I'm just not sure if everything is good. I don't really like how that looks. It's not a very good connection in my eyes, so let's see. Maybe if I release it, it will come back down. Oh no, never mind. I guess I was wrong. Whatever. So I'm going to go and get this one connected up, and I'll see you guys near the end once everything is all set up. Thank you. So yeah, it seems like our crane here was somewhat successful. I don't know how well this actually is all set up and everything. The one thing I will say is that this is definitely a lot different than anything I've ever done as far as how the crane is set up and just everything. It just doesn't... It's really weird. That's all I can say. So I'm going to put... Who is this? Mr. Bill? You did way too much right now, and I think you deserve a little bit of a break. But we definitely need to get some kind of a command module on here. The main problem is that we can't really control very much, and we can't really do anything as far as if something gets disconnected and then reconnected or anything like that. There we go. Get up there. You worked pretty hard today, sir. You need a definite break. So who's in here? There's Jeb and Bob. They all get their own separate container. So let's see how well this... this one looks like it's not fully down or something. I don't know. But the main problem is that we can't actually disconnect anything. We just basically can't do anything because there's no command module. So that is a bit of a problem. The one thing I was thinking I could do is I could reroute the command through here from the crane or something. I'm gonna try that out off camera, but anyways guys, if you like what you see here, subscribe. There's always more to come. To all you new people, welcome. And yeah, I will see you next time.